gentlemen, and welcome to our Roaring Twenties in Review. Starting the entire crew staff, some crew, and a cast of thousands!
Said to the Norwegian officer last night?
No.
That's right.
Okay. And now a lady you all know, she sings for us now and adds to our show. Ladies and gentlemen, your frequently fun coordinator, Miss Paula.
Where's Hey, Vicki. Yes.
I have a riddle for you.
You got a riddle for me? Y'all want to hear a riddle?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Too enthusiastic, was it? Y'all want to hear a riddle?
Yeah.
Oh, they want to hear it. Yes.
Okay. What has two arms, two legs, wears blue, is very sexy, and hums?
Let's see. You said two arms, two legs, wears blue, and it's very sexy, and hums. Gosh, I don't know. You gotta laugh, they don't get any better, right? This is the whole nine yards here. Oh, a maternity ward.
What's
this? It's bad. Here's your money there.
What a time for my wife to be having a baby. We're on our vacation.
What are you complaining about? I'm on my honeymoon.
All right, moving along now. Consuela!
Señor!
Consuela, did you hear the really, really big news?
The really, really, really big news?
Si, they found a dead fish in the church.
A dead fish in the church? Holy mackerel!
Consuela! Consuela!
Si, señor!
Did you hear the really, really big news?
No, the really, really, really big news?
See, the church is on fire.
The church is on fire? Holy sh...
Smoke.
Holy smoke!
Consuela! Consuela!
Si, senor!
Did you hear the really, 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 really big news?
No.
The septic tank truck ran into the church.
The septic tank ran into the church. Holy sh!
Hey, Kevin.
Hey, what's that? Hey. All right.
Hey, Denny, do you know the difference between mashed potatoes and pea soup?
Difference between mashed potatoes and pea soup? Sure. I'm sorry. Hey, Kevin, how you doing, buddy?
All right. Say, Denny, do you know the difference between mashed potatoes and pea soup?
No.
You can mash potatoes, but you can't.
Kevin Ross. Look, it's horny little Steve. That's Orange. Who's your pet? Got a new pet.
Yeah. I'd like you to meet my friend Nuts.
Nuts?
Yeah, he does tricks.
Nuts, that's a very unusual name for an animal.
Uh-huh.
And he does tricks?
Yeah.
You kidding?
No. Well, I mean, he does tricks.
Where were we?
I'm the director over here, this whole fiasco. What?
What? Nuts. Nuts.
Nuts.
Yes. Tricks. Watch this. You're gonna like this, Denny.
We are?
Yeah. No, you are.
I am. That's why everybody's tongue.
Ah!
There you go. Oh! It's a tongue back there. Yeah, that's right.
Watch this. Say yes, Nuts! Say no, Nuts!
Hey, that's good!
Does
he talk?
Yeah!
He does?
Say speak, Nuts.
Speak, Nuts.
Oh, he's adorable. Listen!
Come here, I'm gonna give him a treat.
What are you gonna give him?
A peanut.
No, Denny, a peanut!
Well, I wanted to sit in the front row. We here with Christina Hanson, gents. We sing the sweet song just for you. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the pastry men on board. Please welcome Senior Fleming.
Yeah, buddy.
She was in it.
He's our special guest every cruise, and when he said he played the 20s, he made an offer we just couldn't refuse. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the dining room waiters, Mr. Henry Hildago!
Have you seen the well-to-do up and down Park Avenue on that famous little pair with their noses in the air? High hats and a roof for us, white spots and lots of dollars, spending every night for a wonderful time. If you do, have you done, where do you go to, why don't you go for a special tip? What is that there is? Different types who wear a day coat, pants with tights, and got a way coat, perfect fit. What in other is? Strolling up the avenue so happy. All the passes like an English abbey. There's nothing. Homeless means we're rock and fast. We're so twisted. Our umbrellas just in their wits. What in other is? Strolling up the avenue so happy. All this art is like an English habit. There's nothing. Come, let's mix with Rockefeller. Let's walk with the umbrellas in their midst. Put it on the...
Excuse me, but Nancy.
What?
Look at the list, you're in the wrong place.
Okay.
No, Nancy, you're in the wrong place in the show.
Did you hear what the young lady said to the Norwegian officer last night?
Haven't we been through this twice already?
That's right.
A poem. By Kevin Jerome Robson. Little Mary had a watch. She swallowed it one day. So little Mary took a pill to pass the time away. The pill, it did not work. The time, it did not pass. So if you want to know the time, just look up Little Mary's brother, who also has a watch. Thank you.
Now we present a song you all know, and here's Phoenix from the dining room, so sing along. Ladies and gentlemen, one of your dining room waiters, Mr. Phoenix Hewitt!
We have
finally found Fred the right part.
I'm a loser. I'm a failure. I got a wife and six kids. Can't even support them. I'm a total failure. There's only one thing left to do. I'll shoot myself.
Hello there, miss. Good body.
Hi, Dr. Spock.
This is Sawbones, Dr. Sawbones.
Oh, excuse me. Hi, Dr. Sawbones.
What can I do for you today?
Well, I'm really desperate. I'm here to see about my brother. It's not about me.
What's wrong with your brother?
Well, he thinks he's a chicken.
Well, why don't you take him to the veterinarian and get him fixed?
Well, we would, but we need the eggs.
Hello there, miss. Big Bottom.
Well, hello there, Doctor. Too little.
Well, what can I do for you today?
Well, I'm not here to see about me. I'm really desperate. I'm here to see about my other brother. Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with him?
Well, he thinks he's a dog.
Well, how long has he had that problem?
Ever since he was a puppy.
There's more?
Yeah. Okay.
Not in the script.
Hi, Dr. Shibago.
Hello. Say nothing.
Hello, fine.
What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm not here to see about my brother or my other brother, but it's about me. I've been having strange, strange dreams, and I'm really worried about it. I think it can have psychological implications. It could lead to physical implications. Well, last night I dreamed that I was a... I dreamed that I was... This is serious! No, quit laughing, or I'm going to go to another doctor. Okay, well, night before last, I dreamed that I was a wigwam, and then last night, I dreamed that I was a teepee.
Sounds to me you're just too tense.
A poem by Kevin Jerome Robson II.
Kevin Jerome Robson II.
Oh, the second time, not who.
Thank you anyway, though. Mary Brown from Boston, Mass. Stood in the water up to her ankles. It doesn't rhyme now, but it will when the tide comes in. Thank you.
Now it's time for the old song shoe, and here's two dancing darlings to do with you. Ladies and gentlemen, two of your ship's photographers, Mr. Barry Moss and Mr. Chris Mondell.
Hello, Mr. Baker.
Hello.
So how did you enjoy your stay at NCL's Foley Towers?
Why, we had a wonderful time. Thank you.
Well, that's good, because here's your bill for $200.
$200? But we were only here one night.
But the meals were included.
We didn't eat here.
But they were there for you.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to deduct $100 from this bill because I happen to know you were fooling around with my wife.
Well, I was nowhere near your wife.
Well, she was there for you. All right, moving along now. Finally, we're going to bring out a young lady that's going to do a production number for you. She's been out about three or four times in a row. Nancy!
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 I drink to your health when I'm with you, and I drink to your health when I'm alone. And I drink to your health so damn much, I'm just about to lose my own.
You don't feel good. You think you're gonna faint? No, 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 don't faint!
No, no!
Put your leg down, there's a guy in the Zoom lens.
What do I do?
Rubber wrist.
Rubber wrist. I'm rubbing a wrist. That's not doing anything. What should I do now?
Rubber arm.
Rubber arm. Hell, that ain't doing anything. What should I do now?
Rubber arm. Rubber arm. All right, move along now.
Polly, where are you?
Who's next? Holly, where are you?
Holly.
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 Hey,
Holly.
You're missing a prop. It's a mirror. Go back there and find the mirror. This is what you call rehearsal next week on early Monday morning.
I heard a little one.
What? What?
That's the mirror.
What? That's the mirror. I heard that. You're supposed to go berserk. A little more screaming. Go crazy. Alright, that's good. Go off and try it again. Alright, coming out now, young lady gonna do a number for you. It's Holly, that's your cue.
Yeah. there?
A who?
Sex hour, sex hour.
Sex hour? We don't even get a coffee break.
Excuse me, miss. Could you direct me to the department that sells the talcum powder?
This way.
If I could walk that way, I wouldn't need the talcum powder. How you doing, Brett?
Hi, Lewis.
Hey.
Yeah.
You know the difference between shower curtains and toilet paper? The difference between shower curtains
and toilet paper.
Right.
Nope.
Captain, I found him!
A poem by Kevin Jerome Robson the Third.
Kevin Jerome Robson the Third.
Thank you. Jack and Jill went up the hill to smoke a little leaf. Jack got high, unzipped his fly, and Jill said,
"Where's the beef?"
Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we dance though, is tops in the 20s, the two-step, the turkey trot. They were fun to do, but we've chosen the Charleston especially for you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Dancing Dolls and the Charleston! That's quite all right, Miss...
Love it.
Okay, Miss Lovett, would you mind telling me why your boss jumped out of his six-story building to his death?
Well, officer, he called me to the office and said, "Miss Lovett, I've been thinking about you a lot lately.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I'm even starting to have dreams about you at night. So I was wondering, if I gave you $100 in cash and promised there'd be no hanky-panky, would you take off your dress and stand there for me in your slip?" Well, you know, $100 is a lot of money for a working girl.
Oh, yeah. $100. Did he keep his promise?
Oh, yes, he did.
There was no hanky-panky.
No hanky-panky.
No hanky-panky. Then he jumped out the window to his death.
Well, no. See, no. Then he offered me $200 in cash.
$200?
If I would take off my slip and stand there in my underwear for him.
Underwear.
And he still promised there'd be no hanky-panky, and $200 is an awful lot of money for a working girl.
$200. And did he keep his promise?
Oh, yes, he did.
There was no hanky-panky.
There was no hanky-panky.
No wanky. Hanky. Then he jumped out the window to his death.
Well, not exactly.
Not exactly.
See, then he offered me $500 in cash. If I would take everything off and say there was nothing on.
Nothing.
And $500 is an awful lot of money for a working girl.
$500. And did he keep his promise?
Yes, he did.
There was no hanky-panky.
There wasn't any hanky-panky.
Then he jumped out the window to his death.
Well, no, see, then he said to me, Miss Lovett, I can't stand it
anymore. I can't stand it anymore.
How much for the hanky-panky?
How much?
So when I told him I usually charge $10.
Then he jumped out the window.
What?
Can I do an impression?
You want to do an impression? Y'all want to see an impression?
Yeah!
All
right, I guess so. This is my impression of a short-eared, long-nosed African elephant.
A short-eared, long-nosed African elephant?
You got like this?
Okay. Any short-eared, long-nosed African elephant?
Oh, this one?
Oh, sorry. Short-eared, oh dear, a stain in my new babushka. I guess I'll have to shout it out. Get the hell out of there!
Thank you, friend.
Oh, yes, sir. Okay, we're standing here again.
Jenny! Jenny!
Huh? Me?
Jenny!
Oh, there.
Yes, you.
What?
Tonight's the night, right?
What?
Tonight's the night, right?
Tonight's the night? Sorry, I have a headache.
Jenny, I want what I want when I want it, and I want it now.
Sorry, sugar, but you'll get what I got when I got it, and I ain't got it now.
Ladies and gentlemen, back in the 20s, they used to do a theatrical piece entitled A Melodrama, and we're going to do one for you this evening, but of course, we need your help. We're going to have Paula eventually coming over here on the side. Paula?
Yeah.
Yes, got the signs?
Yeah.
Yes? Good.
Yeah.
Now, you got to show them out here, not backstage, okay? All right, she's going to have...
Yay! Well, I can get organized, okay.
Just let us know when we're ready, when you're ready.
Okay, I'm ready.
You ready? You sure?
We're going to have Paula coming out here with all kinds of different signs. Because we've got three characters in our melodrama. We've got a hero, a heroine, and a villain. Our hero, he's tall and he's strong. And our villain, our heroine, I should say, is pure as the driven snow. And our villain is so mean! He throws a big party at his house, serves a lot of beer, and locks the bathroom door. That's pretty mean. The title of our melodrama is Virtue is Its Own Reward. Or head for the roundhouse, Nelly. He can't corner you there. But Paula's over on the signage. She's going to hold up three different signs. And those are because of our three different characters, right? And when you see this first sign, what are you going to do? Right. When you see the second sign, what are you going to do this time?
Yeah.
See the third sign, what are you gonna do this time?
Applause. Ladies
and gentlemen, welcome on stage, Miss Nellie! Oh, woe is me, if only my dear father, who at one time was the pillar of society, but since my mama was taken to heaven, he has taken to drinking. If only he were here. But he has been gone since early this morning to the establishment of Squire Sebastian. Squire Sebastian is the nefarious blackguard and saloon keeper who also owns the deed to our house. But Father has gone there to pay the mortgage. Alas, I feel some grave misfortune has befallen him. 'Tis a cold, bitter, snowy night.
No!
Hark! Someone knocked.
Come in.
Come in.
She's a plum, ready for plucking.
What is your business here, sir?
Miss Nelly, I have come to inform you that your mortgage is long overdue. And if you do not pay this mortgage by midnight, I said, I will have to foreclose.
But this cannot be, for Father paid the mortgage only this morning.
Bah! Your father lies drunk in my saloon.
Oh, no! But he took the pledge!
But he broke it after I plied him with demon rum.
No.
Did we mess up?
Yes.
Did I mess up?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry.
Where are we?
Oh, no.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes! Thank you.
What? He took the pledge this time.
He took the pledge!
But he broke it after I plied him with demon rum. Well, Miss Nelly, now I shall have her begging for mercy. Miss Nelly, if you do not make payments on this mortgage, I will have to throw you out into the cold, cold snow. Certain privileges.
Oh, no.
Egad, you turn pale, my child.
Oh, what shall I do?
No! What shall I do? If I do not comply with his demands, he will make me homeless. And if I do...
And destitute.
I'll be destitute, too.
Well,
what is your answer?
Ought I? Dare I?
Unless you make payments on this mortgage, you will have to ship for yourself. You heard me!
Alas, crushed by the fickle finger of fate, will no one aid me in my hour of need?
Smitten by her charms.
What is this blush that suffuses my cheek?
A Jim Beam, Jack Daniels, that's who I am. Johnny Quest?
Yes.
Jack Dalton, at your service, ma'am. What's going on here?
Oh, kind sir. Squire Sebastian says if I do not pay the mortgage by this evening, he will make my father
homeless and a destitute. And if I do...
Yeah? Oh, that's you.
But I know.
But I know my father paid the mortgage only this morning.
Thank you.
Then some diabolical deed has been committed by some dastardly villain. I shall bring him to justice. You betcha.
And how would you do that, kind sir?
I'll search his drawers.
I'm off.
Let's go to the saloon to find my father. I hasten.
ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to bring back our players individually because they want your approval and they definitely would not need your applause. And everything he does, he's quite a whiz, and he writes in the corner wherever he is. From the dining room, one of you, dining room winners, Mr. Penis Hewitt! Dives, and when the girls sing in, they break out in hives. Mr. Dick Dallager! He snorkels and dives with the greatest of ease, and everyone thinks that he's the D's knees. Mr. Brad Kurtz! And I think I'd eat with me, and having our show was a real treat. Mr. But just give her a mic and she'll take it away. Miss Vicki Shaw! Coming out now to take her well-deserved bow is our second purser. She sings and entertains us with a song. Miss Linda Cooper! She's our sultry Juliet and many talents she has. She does everything with panache and pizzazz. Miss Holly Quay! But as for the show, it's just another one. Miss Paula last! Her dancing is the light when a rather unfitted. She's young, she's lovely, and she's rather delicious. Our ship's nurse, Miss Nasty Hotline! For doing so well, they deserve a big hand. We acknowledge with them our five-piece band. They play their music like they're having a match. With John Armstrong on the piano, with John qualified. Right now, we're going to wait for a gentleman that's supposed to be out here. Yeah. Steve! Steve?
Hold it! She threw my jacket off! We got
what?
Problems. We got
she
big problems.
Down your jacket?
She's down there. They're holding her back. There's this lady. She got on the cruise. She must have got on the stirrup. And the guys are holding her back. She grabbed me. She said that her husband is on this cruise with another man's wife. She's got a gun.
Wait, whoa. Come now. What?
She's got a gun this big.
She's got a gun that big, but what? Whoa, what? There's a lady on this cruise?
I don't know. She must have got on the stirrup.
She's looking for her husband.
She says that he's on this cruise with another man's wife. She thinks he's in the lounge. She's
going to come. Is a gentleman?
And she's going to shoot him.
Is the gentleman on this cruise with another man's wife?
Yeah.
You're kidding. Listen, if there's any gentleman out in the audience that's on this cruise with another man's wife, quickly wake your way up here. We'll get you up over on the side.
Look at y'all grow fast. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here.
Introduce to you a musical dance who will amaze you with his room. Please welcome Mrs. Annie Anson.
That's me. Bit right now, and this has to do with mainly the crew staff on board the ship. All the crew, of course, we work very, very hard on board the ship. At least we think that we do on board. And you all enjoying the crew so far? Yeah? Okay, yeah. Especially with the crew staff. The crew staff, a lot of people come up to them as the week goes on because we get friendly with you. And a lot of people say, how did you get started on board the ship? Do you enjoy your job? Well, of course, all of us on board. We all enjoy our job, and we do get paid weekly.
Very weekly!
Yeah. But as the week goes on, we get very, very friendly with you, and a lot of passengers come up and say, what did you do before you started on board the ship? And of course, do you enjoy your job? And of course, we do enjoy our job, like we said, on board. But the crew staff especially, we get tired of all those questions all the time coming up. So the crew staff and some of the crew have gotten together, and we've got a little skit for you right now. And it's entitled, The Starward Players. And this is what we would be if we were not upon the sea. If I were not upon the sea, something else I'd rather be. If I were not a diving instructor, a sergeant major me. And as you'd pass me by, this you'd hear me cry. Left, right, swing those bloody arms. Left, right,
Thank you.
gentlemen, while you're in the mood for applause, how about a nice round of applause for the finest orchestra within a 50-mile radius? Thank you, lady. I can't believe I'm not here either. So. She brought the damn town. Look at this. Comb on one side, not on the other. Fix that. All right. We thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us for our Roaring 20s this evening. We certainly hope that you did enjoy it. Stick around because we have got the jazz people coming back here. We have got Mr. Bill Aldred and the American Sound. They'll be in here from 11:30 on. And they'll be all the way until 1. This is kind of nice, though. We've got the microphone. Let's arrest the microphone. Yes, indeed. Nice one.
Smile.
All right. Nice to see you. All right. The night is not over. Like we said, Mr. Bill Aldred and the American Sound, they'll be in here in a few minutes' time. We just need a few minutes to set the stage for them. They'll be in here for your dancing and listening pleasures. There's music happening back in the Orion Nightclub, live casino gambling. Don't forget, Rod is up in the Tropicana's garden as well. Tomorrow morning, we're going to be bright and early in Jamaica. No problem in Jamaica tomorrow. Please make sure that you do look indeed on your cruise news tomorrow, and that will tell you exactly where you have to meet and what time you have to meet for you.
Come here.
Hi, how are you? Are you all on your honeymoon?
Jeez.
Hell no.
Certainly sounded like it. We're going to be in Jamaica tomorrow, like I said. Please make sure that you do look on your cruises on what time and where that you have to meet tomorrow morning. On behalf of the entire cast, this is kind of nice, so I like this. Place to rest the microphone. The crew staff, the players, we're going to be outside of the doors taking pictures with you as you exit, if you like. I'll be over on this side, guys, so... You want to move your lips and say something, please? Hi. How are you? Fine. Oh, she's all interested in that. That's good. We've got a cleanup committee this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you for joining us for Showtime this evening. Whatever you decide to do, have a nice evening on board. Thank you for joining us for Showtime.
Wanted to be a man of mystery. My life's an open book by James Joyce and Agatha Christie. Sometimes I get confused somewhere around page 2. I live the perfect crime. Crime pays more than it used to. They check in the evidence. Charges pressed. The only one they got me on is a misdemeanor. A part of history. I have my days in the sun. A beach bum, a member of seasides. God, his counselor said, your scores are anti-heroic. Computer recommend. Hard drinking Calypso poet. Studied life at sea.
We got plenty of doctors. We got plenty of lawyers. We've got people to make us think. We got people to sell us those things. I never have enough room for those things. I feel lots of self-story. Calypso poet shorty. Calypso poet shorty. Charm this crowd till you snake dance round with Calypso beat down island sound. I can make you dance till you all fall down.
I just want to say you have a new movie coming up, Beyond Therapy, that you just got back.
A little bit ago, I was in Europe. I did a couple of things, actually. Beyond Therapy, the Chris Durang play that Robert Altman turned into a movie version. He's terrific. And Glenda Jackson's in it, and Tom Conti, and Chris Guest, and Julie Haggerty, and me. And it's a romantic comedy, and very interesting and very funny, I think, and good. And then I did a thing for the BBC about Watson and Crick, the double helix.
Right.
You know, there's two guys who discovered DNA in the early 50s, and I played Jim Watson, and I like that. And
did you tell me you had to shave your head for that thing?
Not shave my head, but pert near. They gave me a very, very short crew cut. It was 1951. My character comes from America at the beginning of the story, having imitated Oppenheimer and the like, so I'm very kind of very, very short. I was freaked out about getting my hair cut that short. It was after the fly. You didn't see it in that clip, but I had very long hair that I was kind of enjoying, and they generously made me a wig for my own purposes that I, after first trying it on for Gina, when I came back, it's like long. She didn't like it.
I can't decide if women like long hair or short hair. This is a picture of Jeff. This was in a magazine like you... Can we get a picture of this? This is, that's Gina on, well, which is Gina there?
Oh, come on.
And Gina's here tonight, and could we introduce her? Gina Davis, of course, who's a wonderful actress, started in many roles, Tootsie and many others. And give her a warm welcome. Hi, Gina. It's nice to meet you. I don't know how we best do this, but are you comfortable in these seats?
Suddenly
Gina, you and I have never met, and I was just noticing what time it was, and you know, it's running a little slow. Maybe it needs to be wound. I'm not sure. Is that a self-winding? I think I could. Now, did you? It's very nice to meet you, and you're a wonderful actress, and
nice to meet you.
Really. And how did you meet Jeff? No, I knew it was Jeff. Yeah.
We met making the film Transylvania 65,000 in Zagreb, Yugoslavia.
Right.
In which I was like a vampire and he was a reporter. And
you fell in love?
Yeah, kind of right away. Yeah.
We did.
And see, now, Jeff, you look in love.
Right.
Yeah, although you're looking at me, so it's confusing. He has that look in his eyes, you know, that a dog gets when you save him from the humane system.
no compassion, no compromise. We can't trust the insect. I'd like to become the first insect politician. You see, I'd like to, but, oh, I'm afraid,
I don't know what you're trying to say.
I'm saying, I'm an insect who dreamt he was a man and loved it. But now the dream is over and the insect is awake.
No, sir.
I'm saying, I'll hurt you if you stay.
Great, and you never look better. We have to take, are we taking a break? We'll come right back. Hang in there. Come right back. Yes, it's great.